Hello, everyone. Welcome back to Vintage. I should start this week with an apology, I think, because in last week's video, there was a big chunk of sound missing. I'm very sorry. I don't really know what happened there. And I'm hoping that, obviously, this week you'll be able to hear 100% of what I've got to say without the need for any speech bubbles or captions over here. Thank you to everybody who watched and commented. And the lucky person who will be receiving that copy of Nemesis by Misha Glennie is Janet Rawlings. Congratulations, Janet. If you look at the bottom of this video's description, you'll find my email address. Send me your postal address and I'll get that book off to you in the post. Now, you wait a few weeks for a non-fiction book to come along and then suddenly two come along at once. Yes, I'm looking at non-fiction again this week. And this is a book which anybody who read The Hare with Amber Eyes will be very intrigued to know about. It is the new book from Edmund De Waal, and it is called The White Road. I have it here in my hand, and if you don't mind, I'm going to spend at least a minute talking about how beautiful this book is in the flesh. It has a lovely sort of minimalist cover design here, but it also has gorgeous paper inside. It has a ribbon, which I always like in a book, just makes it feel somehow a little bit more special. But also, one thing that's really special about this book is that it is written in a special font, an entirely new font to us here at Vintage. And I don't know why that makes such a big difference, but it just makes it more interesting to read for the eye because it's not a font that you are used to seeing. It's a very beautiful font. I'm not going to sort of hold this book up because you won't be able to see it, but maybe I'll flash some pages across the screen. It's just one of the ways in which this book is a very, very beautiful object in and of itself. Underneath this rather minimalist cover, we have some even more minimalist design here on the side. All the writing is embossed rather than printed. It's just a beautiful thing. So for those of you who like the book as object, you may want to get this book for that reason alone. There is, of course, much inside it that would make it worth reading. And The White Road is well, in fact, it has a subtitle, A Pilgrimage of Sorts. It is a pilgrimage of sorts, and it is Edmund De Waal looking at the history of the material that he works with every day, and in fact, that he's been working with for 45 of his 50 years, porcelain. And what he does is to basically trace its history to find where it came from and how it has travelled all the way from the hills of China across the world, across Europe, into England and beyond. And it's a brilliant combination of history, sort of travel writing, and memoir. You get a lot about Edmund's personal relationship with porcelain, but also some really, really fascinating history about how porcelain is connected to some of the great historical events. And having been referred to at one point as white gold, because it was such a sort of precious commodity, you see how the men who made it and the men who wanted to make it were all governed by this obsession with this white clay. Of course, the perfect person to talk about this is not me, it's Edmund himself. And I cannot stress to you what a brilliant guide and writer he is in this book. It's sort of written as a series of fragments, really. It's a bit like taking a porcelain vase or pot and smashing it to pieces. And then from those pieces, you can assemble the history of porcelain. And as you go through and you read these little fragments, which take us sort of here, there and everywhere, it's not a sort of linear history. It is a story that is told with Edmund De Waal's trademark sort of wit and knowledge and humour. And it makes for, as I say, a very enjoyable read. What I thought of when I first heard about this book, I really wanted to know more about where Edmund works and how he does it and how that might affect, you know, the kind of book that he was writing. And so I wanted to go to his studio and I got the opportunity to do that. And so what I'm going to share with you underneath this video is a proper exclusive because nobody else has seen this yet. But I got the chance to go to Edmund De Waal's studio and to find out where he works, what he needs to work, what has influenced his work. And he is just completely adorable. So I really, really recommend that you watch this film. I'll put a link to it here, but also there'll be a link underneath this video. And you will find that he is witty, erudite, interesting, incredibly generous with his time. And you will find out in that video as well why my metaphor of a broken pot is not a misplaced one. The history of porcelain, breaking is as important as making, as you will discover from this film, and as you will discover even more from the book. I just loved it. I can't recommend it highly enough. If you were somebody who loved The Hare with Amber Eyes, you probably don't need much convincing. But if, like me, you have never even considered Porcelain as something that you would want to read about, I found my sort of perspective on it completely changed by this book. I started looking at my terribly cheap plates from a Swedish shop, which we don't need to mention, and sort of wondering what it might be like to see some proper porcelain. And the descriptions of it and the pictures of it in the book are great, but I got the opportunity to actually see some of the historical pieces that he mentions. And when you see these amazing objects and this porcelain, which is so thin that light shines through it, it really does make you see things in a very different way. And that, frankly, is what the real magic of books can be sometimes, because it makes you see the world in a completely different light. So there you go. That is The White Road by Edmund De Waal, a fantastic book. And as I say, do watch that film, because it's my little gift to you, something that I wanted to do, and I'm really quite pleased with it. So there you go. If you would like to win a copy of The White Road, you know what you have to do. Make sure you're subscribed, leave a comment underneath, and I will pick 3 lucky people to win a copy next week. There we go. Thank you for joining me. I will see you next week when, who knows, there may be another non-fiction book, but it will certainly be something marvellous. I will see you then. Take care.